Morning everyone, we are at Orange Rocks. Sunrise. Couple of shad are coming out. Not many. There comes one. Donovan got one. There we go, Proven has got one. Creek is on. Nice big one. Looks as if one pitters on to a shad. Coming out now. He missed. There we go. Nice big one. A miss, Pete.
Miss, my man. Paramus.
Paramus. The shad are a nice size. Nice big ones this morning. There we go. Anthony's got one. Come, Anthony, bring it. Let's see. Lovely. Nice one. Nice. Donovan is on. Jacob is on.
Away, Jacob!
Jacob!
Yeah, Jacob! Yeah, yeah.
Coming!
comes a big one. Watch the water run. Again. Wow, nice one, Anthony. Nice big one.
Catch it for that, buddy.
Okay, everybody. I just want to show you how to bleed a shad. You've got to cut it right here at the tip. Take and cut it off. Cut that off and leave and watch the blood come out there. See the blood coming out? Look at it. Just look at it. See? If you bleed a shad, you can't believe the difference in the taste. Really bleed a shad. Okay. I managed to catch four shad, so we're going to make some crumbed shad today. Okay, everyone. Okay, we're going to fillet the shad quickly and we're going to make some crumbed shad today. Let's quickly fillet the shad, ones I caught this morning. You'll see, I've bled these shad. Now when you fillet it, there's no blood inside the fish. Look there, it's pure white, no blood. Side. That's it. Give me another one quickly. See that? Absolutely no blood. Okay, now I'll show you what we're going to do with the carcasses. My dogs love fish, so my next video will show you how we prepare the carcasses for the dogs. Now we're going to debone the fish. pin bones are over there. Got out the pin bones. Yeah. This one I cut a little bit deep, so we've got to cut out the little bit of ribs that I've managed to get into it. Take that out. There we go. Pin bones. That's it. I felt a little bone over there on the side. Get that one out. Pin bone. No more bones there. Pin bones. See, it's just a little V you cut into the shad over there and you've got all the bones out. Got that done. See how clean the fillets are. There's absolutely no blood in them. This one is a little bit red. I suppose it was half dead when I cut it. That's it. Okay. I'm going to cut them into strips. The kids love the shad when it's cut into strips. I call them, well, they call them Kentucky Fried Fish Sticks. I'll cut them into every fillet into three pieces. Crumb them and then fry them. Okay, and I've cut them all up. I'll show you how to crumb them. I have some lemon and herb spice. We're just going to spice the fish with some lemon and herb. Oh, the kids absolutely love this. My grandkids go crazy over it. Okay, going to add some crumbs to the dish. Put quite a bit because there's a lot of fish there. Can't believe four fish make such a lot of sticks. Just going to add some corn flour. About 3 teaspoons. And we mix it up. Let's mix that corn flour up into the crumbs. Again, now we're going to break an egg into the dish. Two eggs, there's such a lot of fish there. There we go, 2 eggs. And we're gonna just mix it up. To it. fillet, dip it into the egg mixture, and then just roll it in the crumbs. There we go. Perfect. Next one. Dip it into the egg mixture and roll it. See? Now it's all crumbed up. Another one into the egg mixture and roll it. There we go. Another one. Roll it. Okay, I'm gonna crumb the rest of them and then we'll fry them when they're finished. Okay, I've crumbed all the fillets. Now I'm just going to put the stove onto a low heat. Yeah. That's it. Just let the oil get warm a little bit. Okay, we'll start adding the warm a little bit. See how nice it's crumbed. That corn flour makes it stick very well to the fish. Okay, we're going to start putting them in. Well, it's still a little bit cold, but it will warm up quickly. Put in about 5 at a time and you just fry it until it's a nice golden brown. Yeah, it's starting to fry. Won't take long. One thing about fish, it goes very quickly. And most people these days like their fish raw, eat sushi. That's going quite well. Go another couple of seconds and we can turn them around. Okay. No, not quite there yet. We can go a little bit longer. Smell. Smell is so delicious. Oh. And the grandkids go absolutely crazy about this fish. Well, it's nice and brown. I suppose there's more heat that side. Let's put it over. Oh, making me so nice and hungry now. There's so many different ways to do shad. That one is ready. Put it on the paper to absorb most of the oil. See, they've just got to be a nice golden brown. Another five quickly. Oh, that's a big one. I never cut that one in all. But anyway. Now you'll see how quickly it goes because the oil is warmer. Around. Oh, and they are so nice and crispy when they come out, yeah. Something about breadcrumbs that makes everything crispy. Okay, those are done. Okay, let's put in another five. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed my video. Subscribe and click the notification bell so when there's new videos coming out, you'll be notified. Thank you for watching.